I can't tell you how relieved I am to see you safe. James. James was assigned as my very first hunter the moment we both graduated at 18. He'd shown remarkable promise in school, basically skipping all of the junior nonsense that they force on you. I, too, had impressed, so we were placed together in the hopes that we'd become unstoppable. We were inseparable in the field together for decades, until I took this post as Lieutenant General. But, as well as being my subordinate, he was also my partner. My husband. For nearly 10 years, yes. But we'd known each other forever. I failed the hunter initiation quite dramatically, and he was taken away to his father's home country to train to become what I'd always dreamed of becoming. Life had other plans for me, but we still found each other in the end. He used to joke that we were destined, the romantic fool. I really don't think it's sunk in that he's gone just yet. I keep thinking he's going to walk through my door, covered head to toe in blood and grime, with a stupid, wonderful grin on his face. They say that people deal with grief differently, but I haven't quite figured mine out just yet. I apologize for not telling you, but it was important to me that I could trust you first. My judgment has been impaired, I'll admit it. Though this turn of events isn't exactly what I expected. All I can think about now is justice. about the others that died before him, and what we could have done to stop it. What I could have done to stop it. I will need you to speak to Augustus about this. They know more about psionic magic than anyone here. I'm sure they'll be able to help you figure this out. I do not trust anyone else. Did he truly not say anything else? Yes. Well, he's all I can think about, too. A curse now, I suppose. He was a cocky son of a bitch, but it worked well for him in the field. He was never careless, though. I often found myself watching him instead of paying attention to whatever was attacking us. Luckily, he could fight well enough to protect us both, or I'm sure we'd have been in trouble. A lot of enforcers choose to stay cooped up in a stuffy office away from all that danger. Working with James made me not want to miss a thing. We were unbearable to be around, I'm sure. Well, apparently he appears to have taken a liking to you. It's only fair for you to put a face to the name, I suppose. What happened tonight could have been prevented. It's unacceptable that we were so aware of the looming threat, and yet we let our guard down and lost another life. This cannot happen again. There's nothing more you can do here until we've identified the victim. Get some rest. It's late. You're dismissed, Hunter.
Distracted